looks really great. It's that great feeling, you know, in April or early May when like everything is like set, you know, in your landscaping. It does make it feel nice. And it will slow weeds, but mulch is not a weed preventer. So don't say I'm gonna mulch it because I don't wanna have to weed. You're gonna have to weed. But mulch will help slow it because a lot of the weed seeds germinate because they're exposed to sunlight. And if they don't get any sunlight, then they won't germinate. But if you got dandelions or other stuff that is coming out from roots out of the ground, then you're kind of out of luck. It's making a difference. But it will slow the weeds because a disturbed site, disturbed soil, the weeds will wake up right off the bat. So you gotta be careful. So you do need to mulch, but the most important time to mulch is right after you plant. Yeah. Ah, you guys are like right on target here. What is or isn't mulch? Shredded bark is kind of the most common one that people get a hold of. There's like hemlock or there's oak or cedar and things like that. It's the bark that they collected after, you know, after the lumber process took place, and then they turn it into a mulch. I think I've even seen eucalyptus bark. Shredded bark is a good one. I would have to say the finer textured mulch is always a better choice in and around the house and sort of in a landscaping setting because it looks a little bit nicer and it'll break down a little bit more quickly and not just sort of bleach out. Sometimes the big hunks can kind of bleach out after a while and it doesn't look so good. So I like to go with a finer texture in a landscaping setting.
Yeah. Christmas trees, they invite you to take it home.
Oh.
Good mulch.
I had bad experience. People don't take away the ornaments.
Oh no.
And you get your tree, but you get the other people's tree. You're like.
And you get some of their ornaments and stuff, or their tinsel.
And I never again because. Yeah.
It's a little too fresh, actually, is part of the problem, and especially being an evergreen like that. It's like if somebody cut down a pine tree nearby, and then they say, well, you want a bunch of free wood chips? I'm kind of like, no, because there's too many tannins and all that stuff inside of the evergreens. It's not the best. I would rather, if it's chipped, and you could still, it's not completely useless, but I would want it to sit for a while. If they're selling it right away, I'm not happy with it. But if they're letting it compost for a year or so, then I think it's perfectly fine.
It's free.
It's free, and that's the other one. I mean, I do the same thing. I'll if I'm pruning plants and stuff like that, I'll just cut everything into a bunch of pieces, I'll throw it in the composting pile, or I'll just let it sort of biodegrade. I mulch with just leaves, you know, and things like the leaves that I pick up. You can use your leaves as a mulch, and it works just as fine.
Is it necessary to put gardening fabric between the ground and the mulch?
No, don't ever do that.
That's a very highly recommended technique.
Yeah, that's the, when I was in school, we were doing that. We were doing that in like sort of, we did it in private housing and also some public housing areas, but it's not the right technique to do it. I pull up fabric now all the time because what you've done is you've sort of killed off the whole kind of interaction between the air and the ground and everything else. You sort of sealed it off. And none of that good organic material works its way into the soil. So you definitely don't want to do it. I remember you cutting holes and putting the daylily in it. But then the daylily never spreads like it could, right? So it's not really real gardening.